But my dad is all like, no, September is when school starts. You have to go. That's what people do. Ugh, civilization, you know? I've actually been thinking about peacing out entirely, going off the grid, seeing what that does. Canada's close. Maybe I can defect.
Yeah, sounds like an interesting idea, Molly, whose last name wouldn't happen
I
to
know.
Be...
I know. Running away is a way to avoid a reality where a void sits and hits hard on your high hopes for happiness. But why would I stay if reality's already faking it in the first place and I could be singular and mingle with the wilderness? That's a fantasy. That's good for me, 'cause usually people are perfectly fine until you finally get to know them. And when they show you colors you'd prefer they hadn't shown, then you're stuck with the truth of the matter, and that'll shatter any friendship we make up till we break up. So let's drop the fake friend shit. I fantasized till I realized that it's no surprise. I'd rather be with the trees. You know what I mean? The green smoke filters through the breeze and blow dries me clean of the mess and the stress of societies and families.
Wow.
'Cause please, in civilization, everyone thinks the problem is somebody else's. She hurts him, and then whose fault is it? Who else his? But nobody knows till after the fact that the problem was probably theirs too. So why try civilized if no one else cares to? It's a mountain to climb every time, and that's why I'm
hanging out with the trees.
They don't say a word, they heard every single one of my pleas.
Every single one.
And then they conferred with their leaves and relieved me from policies and hypocrisies. When you freeze for a second in a world that's beckoning you to go prove something, to go be something. It's right.
Yeah.